And it's fantastic. Welcome, everyone. I'm Brendan Walsh, Father of the Bride. It's a distinct honor and privilege to hear you say that. Well, first of all, gave her away. I'll keep my comments brief, but I would like to start with some thanks. Thank God. All goodness has come from. And for this day, I'd like to thank our friends at St. Henry Mission for opening the bridge, for being introduced to us. It's a beautiful place. We felt how awesome. I'd like to thank Father Ian. He gave a great personal sermon. Did a great job. Thank my beautiful bride, my best friend over there, Patsy. She is a tremendous woman. She's even a better mother. She's the best mom ever, I think it was, when we have a mug in our kitchen of food. I'd like to thank Mike and Rita. Such a fine young man and Andy. A class act. And what a wonderful family. Just love and respect. It's just amazing. It's just beautiful. Thank you. I'd like to thank all of you for coming today. It means the world to me. I'm sure it means the world to him. And rest. So you'll hear rest and honor when you change. And last but not least, Aaron and Andy. Thank you so much for allowing us to share this day with you. It's absolutely awesome. You know, I know the last several months have been easy. Been pretty tough. But I knew you guys had faith. You had faith in God, you had faith in each other. And you were going to breathe life into that dream of getting married into a church. And you did. Commitment for that. It wasn't easy. Yeah, several months we were talking about you two supporting each other. It was even better. Awesome. You know, it wasn't easy on me, I gotta tell you that, because I had to write two Father of the Bride speeches before this one. I'm making this one up as I'm going right now. This is all I got. The first one wrote itself. Think about this. They were gonna get married on the 4th of July. Two kids, we're gonna have two kids, but two young adults were gonna lose their independence on that day. Came and went, no wedding. Next one, I can't make this stuff up. Labor Day weekend, and that speech was all about labor. It had nothing to do with industry. I mean, it was all about the children coming. I was a parent. So that came and went. But it was good. And now I'm looking around and I'm thinking, wow, here we are in the middle of September, and I got nothing. I mean, I don't have, and I found out, a friend of mine actually told me, I can't make this stuff up. He said, friend, you're going to love this. I love good powder jokes. I heard, right? And you know what today is? Today is actually internationally recognized as Talk Like a Pirate. And there's our connection with Pennsylvania and Pittsburgh. So think about that. Unfortunately, the mascot's a pirate for a baseball team that plays on the wrong side of the state. And so not everybody can be from Philly. So I'm not gonna go into the funny stories about your formative years and stuff. I'm gonna let Stephen and Kate take care of that. I just wanted to share a couple of things with you. And again, some things that some friends said to me. Parents find true joy when children find true love. Truer words have never been spoken. It's ever been by my heart. I want to leave you, well, I'm just going to go right to the toast, sorry. Bless. Extremely proud father, with a joyful heart, I'd like to request respectfully that you join me in a toast to my daughter, Ellen, my new son, Lee, Mr. and Mrs. Newton. bell isn't a bell until you ring it. Song is no song until you sing it. With love in your heart, it's not meant to stay. Love isn't love until it's given away. I wish you all the love and happiness and joy of a lifetime. From this day forward, God bless you and bless you.
Where do we go from here?
No. Thanks, though.